Chris Middleton is out there with Jay. And it's Cantor in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And for New York, Barrett and Randall are in the forward position. Trier out there with Elfrid Payton. And it's Robinson in at the five down low. Now here's Payton. Randall outside. Jay with the block.
Crazy to think scouts were saying that Shea didn't play with enough heart. That clock showing you that he wants it.
Middleton on the wing. The Celtics working the ball around. Inside. Just five on the clock. And that one, no good to start him off the line. Four on threes, they bring it up. Here's Barrett. Cross contact on the shot. And now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
And physical, Barrett creating the contact there to draw the foul.
New York shooting their first free throw tonight. Passes it to Cannon. Kicks to Walker. Austin shooting their first free throws of the game right now. That free throw, no good.
Well, you saw this kind of leadership early on from Shea. Even sitting out a tournament game in college, and he was protesting the treatment of one of his teammates. That's taking a stand.
And he sinks the second. About 1 minute into the first quarter. And the foul called on Shea. That is his first foul of the game. Shot will not fall. Now the Celtics take it the other way. Looking to start a new streak after losing on Monday.
And the fact they still had a chance to win that game, I find to be somewhat amazing, because it was clearly an off night for most of their guys.
I'll tell you, if they had pulled that game out, it would have been an amazing win, because they made a bunch of mistakes, nothing was going their way, and somehow they still nearly won it.
Back up. And it's Jay missing. The Knicks are calling games 1-4 to get this game started. Here's Trier, guarded by Smart. On the pass to Barrett. Six on the shot clock. New York needs to get off a shot. Payton. New York, no good that time either.
Still searching out their offensive game right now. 1 of 5 from the field to start this one.
Robinson with the block. Hey, if you're just tuning in, we played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Now, here's Cantor. And here's Walker outside. Robinson pulls it in. New York trailing.
Real close, and I'm sure next time you might time that a little bit better and get a hand on it.
Looking at who's out there now for the Knicks, Marcus Morris comes in for Robinson, and it's Knox in for Trier. So Boston going with almost an entire new group. Daniel Tice is checked in for Canton. Jason Tatum comes in for Chris Middleton. Checked in for Smart, and Smith subbed in for Walker.
Great in transition. Langford makes himself available, and boy, he knows how to finish.
And so New York calls timeout their first.
And they just can't seem to get going offensively.
Yeah, they're like a four-day-old soda right now, just flat, Greg. They're missing shots left and right and just not playing their best.
So for the Knicks. The Celtics have made 3 of their first 5 foul shots tonight.
Versatility Middleton offers up is exceptional. A capable defender, a good scorer, an effective shooter. These are the kind of switchblade players the coaches love.
Another foul would give him 3
Celtics. Walker in toward the guard. Shea is out there with Chris Middleton, and it's Cantor in at the center position. Now, here is Morris. Plenty of daylight on that shot.
Balance and body control look a little bit better this season, so Randall stays on the ground in this catch-and-shoot situation and looks fluid.
He has a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. Shea in the last game against the Knicks was superb. He ended up with 21 points and worked hard on defense, supporting a number of block shots and steals as well. This is why he's considered a star player. The way he carried his team was incredible. Kevin, we'll see if he can do it again tonight.
David, we appreciate the update. Greg, he was sensational the other night, making play after play after play.
And that's what you want. Not only was the effort there, but how about the production as well?
He can do a lot of different things, so he falls into these different roles. Which will it be tonight?
And so here is New York, following the miss by Jay. Here's Robinson, and plenty of contact on the shot. So, two free throws coming up. And the foul goes against Boston. The Knicks have shot 67% from the line, going 6-9. Robinson hits them both. It's Walker with the ball, bringing it up for the Celtics. On the wing, Chain. Free throw line jump shot, and it's good. 2 points, and the Celtics lead by three.
And it seemed like they couldn't get anything to fall in that opening quarter, but you can just feel the momentum starting to shift.
Here's Trier, fouled on the shot, picks up 2 points, so one free throw coming up.
Still able to get that one to go down.
Celtics making a switch here. Murray's checked in. The Knicks have shot the ball pretty well from the line, going 8 of 11.
More good work on the glass there. When it's all said and done, I think rebounding might tell the story in this game.
This is the thing about Cantor. He has the size to muscle through contact and the good touch to boot.
Walker dishes to Chain. That falls. Nice feed that time from Walker. Shea's got the lead up to 5 now for the Celtics. The Knicks have gone 5 of 11 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. Trier passes to Morris. Back to Trier. Shea with the block, and he gets it back.
No question, he got blocked on that shot.
The Knicks have made 8 of their 12 free throws in this game. The first one falls for the Knicks. Bobby Portis is checked in for Mitchell Robinson. And it's Knox in for Marcus Morris. The Celtics also changing it up. Robert Williams is checked in for Cantor. Tatum comes in for Chris Middleton. And Smith subbed in for Walker.
As we've gotten closer to halftime, their style has become more and more physical.
The Celtics shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here. And the Knicks making a change here. Payton's checked in. And the Celtics also making a change. Einberg's checked in for Murray. Knicks trail by 5. And stolen by Chain. Down low. Smith gets it to go on the assist by Chain.
There's something about it. The game feels like it's slowing down out there for Chain, who's seeing the whole court.
Payton outside. Side Portis gets the 14 foot of the fall.
Yeah, this is what you love about it, the confidence on that mid range.
That's a staple of his offensive attack, and proving once again he can do some damage in that area.
7 second difference, shot and game clock, beyond the arc. The shot, no good.
Well, you know, they're in the lead, but he's still been frustrated from an offensive point.
It'll go. The Boston lead is cut down now to just 3 on the bucket from Knox.
Pretty simple, sweet stroke there from Kevin Knox.
Here's Smith. Again, the Celtics good for 2.
Yeah, you got to get up tighter than that. Some players you can give that much room to, but not him.
So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway. Thank you, David, for that interview, and we'll see you back here after the break. And we're back with you, all set to bring you more action from Game 3. One of the stories here, Marcus Smart getting it done today.
With so much on the line tonight, you have to be impressed with the way he came out and set the tone with his aggression.
Yeah, the rest of the team seemed to line right up behind him, matching that kind of intensity and looking for him to come through with some big plays.
It's Randall and Robinson at the four and the five. Payton is out there with Tripp, and it's Barrett at the small forward position. And that's the group for Nate Fisdale as they begin the second half. Here's Chet, following the basket by Alfred Payton. Jay outside. Launches a three. Connects from three-point range. Jay's got 6 points in the quarter.
Yeah, there's 6 points on consecutive three balls. They're finding holes now in the deep.
Handle with the ball. Jay's there. Shot. Five on the clock. Pass to Tripp. On deep. And Chris Middleton pulls it down.
And that was a little bit of a range check for him.
Well, I thought they played smart, and then all of a sudden it was maybe a little too flashy there, and that's unfortunate.
And Smart over to help. Stolen by Smart. The drive by Chet, and Jay throws it down.
Zero hesitation to take that on the inside. Jay aggressive on that.
Payton surveying the floor, and Payton throws it down hard.
And your point guard's got to be the captain.
Smart does a great job getting to the 10.
Well, Greg, he knows when they need a lift.
Did you see how much air he had under him? Wow.
And now, the first timeout called here for Boston. A different look for New York. Ties. Seconds left in the third. Here's Knox, guarded by Tatum. Shot clock at six. Trier passes to Randall. Kept alive. Here's the Celtics with the ball. They're on a 14-5 run. Smith outside. Back to Jay. Can he keep it going? And 10 shot. And Williams with the layup. And the Celtics lead by 18.
Yeah, hard trying to keep Williams off the boards. He makes it a mission to keep possessions alive.
Mr. Randall. And the last shot before the buzzer is off. And so it's Jay making things happen for the Boston Celtics. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. Back right after this. Here now a chance to show you our assist of the game. And it's presented as always by State Farm.
And just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball. And how about the perfect delivery?
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that you want to put on a canvas. Just beautiful basketball.
And we're with you again as our round one coverage continues. And a look at the five for the Celtics to start the fourth quarter. Smith is out there with Bruce Middleton. Then it's Tatum. Then it's Dennis Kent. And it's Jay at the first one. Outside Tatum. From deep three-point range. And Jay with the basket on the assist by Tatum. 16 points for Jay.
Now this is more like it. 9 points for him from three-point range this half. That's nine more than he had before.
Knox misses.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
It's deflected.
This has to energize Barrett. He needs to keep bringing this type of intensity to the defensive end.
Second shot opportunity, and Portis finishes inside.
Second chances are a great measure of what a team is doing in terms of their effort on a nightly basis, and that was some serious effort there.
Here's Here's Jay. Puts it up from 12. Again, Jay missing. Knicks trail by 17. In the corner, Knox with it. From outside the arc, it's hauled in by Jay. Jay's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Middleton up top. You can't hit that time. Handle with some nice deep. For New York, they've gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
Well, that kind of activity from Kevin Knox is going to pose some problems for the defense.
Robinson's checked in for New York. Alfred Payton comes in for Barrett. The Celtics also changing it up. Smart comes in for Chris Middleton. And it's Kemba Walker in for Ish Smith. Now here's Smart. Over Payton. Tries again. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
And back when I first saw him in Summer League, one of the things that I liked about Shea was that he invites the contact, does not shy away from those kind of plays.
Impeccable from the line since halftime.
And New York making a change here. Owens is checked in.
Maybe a time to rest him right now. Just give him a bit of a breather. Try to help him get back on track.
Payton outside. The feed now to Randall. Second chance effort. Out to Payton. Celtics. Cantor's got 6 rebounds in the game. Tatum on the wing. Pass to Walker. Now Smart. Cantor trying to free himself up. Smart misses.
Well, a lot of players in the league are going to make that shot, and for him, it's pretty much automatic. It's a good defensive effort to prevent the layup.
Austin leading by 17. And 2 free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. Julius Randle picks one up.
All of that earned right there. It's become Chase's mantra since he's gotten into the NBA.
Free throw. Good. Chase. Checked in for the Knicks. And both free throws good for Chase. So Payton will bring it up for the Knicks. So far in the fourth quarter, they've allowed just 6 points. The pass to Tripp. And the wide open shot for Morris. And again, it's the Knicks missing.
Well, the D really getting away with one there. No one on him. And that's going to be good 9 out of 10 times.
2 points. That one goes. Chase got 16 here in the second half.
Man, as a player, you've got to relish and soak up and sponge nights like this. Jay clicking.
One shot.
Twenty-9 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Pass to Robinson. 19 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Jay inside. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time.
And once they smelled blood in the water, you could see the killer instinct take over.
Yeah, up until that point, a competitive game, but once they broke through that barrier, it was all them. Complete control.
And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. And they've edged in front of the... performance here in game 3.
Kevin, it sure was. When teams split the first 2 games of a series, game 3 means